其实打猎鹰就是的诀窍，就是一定要打很快，就是不能跟他们一个一个打，就是因为他们就是跑慢，就所以我们要利用我们的优势打快攻，然后就是不要慢下来，就是不要跟他们打阵地战。
最惊奇的是巴西最后那一个三分球，因为我们那时候领先两分，剩下34秒，本来是喊完暂停之后，希望他是拖这一个节奏，结果他刚好跑过去看到一个大空档，就投进那个三分球。我想这是整场最关键的一个节奏，尤其是在篮板部分，我们还可以领先台南。我想这是我们这场球赛赢球的最大的胜利的因素。
We had 19 offensive rebounds, secure the boards. Just, well, I mean, they're big. All you can do is, you know, fight them, trying to keep them out of the paint as much as possible.And then on offense, take advantage of their size and attack, spread them out and attack with the guard.
我们中锋，他们守乌拉跟那个阿秀罗跟德乌拉就守的，就是蛮好的，就是他们比他们矮很多，可是就是有很拼的，就是用力，他们两个都无法的，就是很用力的守住他们。
在昨天比赛的时候几乎是没有手感，我说你来我们球队打前锋，我们需要的最需要希望是你一直在狂得分了，不然我们就用大个子就好。那今天他也适时改变他的打法，拿到球的时候就强势的攻击。
The kind of adjustment I made, you know, I changed what I ate before, pasta, lasagna, you know, got a good night rest. The night before,There was a mosquito that got in my room, so I killed that mosquito, so I was able to sleep better. So I actually got more rest at night.
This guy's called your mosquito kid.
It's a true story.
I drank a bottle of wine and I was good. You know.
Also, you know, I knew the gym was going to be cold, so I actually, you know, wore the proper attire, got here early to get, you know, more shots up.
球员在上半场虽然一度落后多达19分了，但是他们没有放弃过，然后还可以把这个分数给追回来，甚至超前。那这场比赛最后的结果输球，我觉得几个原因呢、啊？第一个就是我们真的球员之间可能真的彼此没那么熟悉啊。之前我们也讲过，我们是一支全新的阵容的一支球队，那其实彼此都还在磨合中。这个礼拜我们又加入了乌拉，当然他绝对是我们在禁区的一个战力了。那其实我们在整个球队，大家都还在磨合、在适应的情况下，我觉得最重要的东西就是给我们一点时间，我们还需要时间。
It's just a learning experience. I've been here 3 days and I'm just learning how to play with them. And I think today we had a really good game. And it's just about building the culture and learning how to win games like that, like really close games. They're a really good team and.The credit to them because they made really big shots and we just need to focus more and come out with a win.